The Grevy zebra is one of Africa's most endangered large mammals, and the Grevy Zebra Trust is working to save this incredible species. Found only in the drylands of Kenya and Ethiopia, the Grevy zebra is striking in its beauty with its tall stature, fine stripes, white belly and large furry ears. With only 3,000 left in the wild, an 80% decline since the 1970s. The basic social structure is a female with one or two of her latest offspring. Grevy zebra females associate with each other based on their reproductive condition, where nursing mothers are found together near water, drinking more frequently to support lactation. Mature males establish territories that contain water and grazing to attract females. Territories are large and can be held for up to 7 years. The behavior of Grevy zebra is closely observed by livestock and herders who use them to predict rainfall, detect predators, and find water and grazing during droughts. Grevy Zebra Trust was established in 2007. Working in a 10,000 kilometer square area in northern Kenya, the trust works to conserve the endangered Grevy zebra and its habitat in partnership with communities.
In Kenya, we have more than 95% of those zebras here. And that's why the Grevy Zebra Trust, which is 100% dedicated to the conservation of Grevy zebra, has been established. The Grevy Zebra Trust works with women, warriors, elders and children to come together around the conservation of the Grevy zebra. And we do this through employment of people to monitor and protect them. We engage the community deeply through workshops, so really identifying issues that they face in their daily lives and helping them to find solutions that they own and drive. And all those actions that they're taking help Grevy zebra and other wildlife because their livelihoods are based on the same resources, so their livestock depends on that same resource.
Women have been uniquely included in our conservation efforts through the Grevy Zebra Scout program. The Grevy Zebra Scouts monitor the Grevy zebra population and foster positive attitudes towards the species. Many of the women that the trust employs are widows or single mothers. They now have greater standing within the community and are also able to provide for their families. The results of their work have been published in a mainstream scientific journal, highlighting their critical role as citizen scientists in long-term monitoring of an endangered species.
And they also engage the community in a really fun, interactive way using glove puppets. And also they're invited to attend community meetings and actually speak on behalf of conservation organisations.
They also reinforce the economic and intrinsic value that the species holds. Overgrazing by livestock has increased. This has largely been driven by nomadic cultures becoming sedentary as a result of much-needed infrastructure development for communities.
As people settle permanently, closer to the shopping centres, closer to the health centres, they are grazing in the same area, same landscape, year in, year out. And what that means is that it's leading to overgrazing.
Community members already have an intimate knowledge of local ecology. We build upon this foundation by exploring ecosystem processes, such as the water cycle, and how grazing management affects ecosystem health.
We're trying to kind of work with local traditions and integrate rangeland management principles and best practice into those traditions to kind of disseminate knowledge on a wide scale.
The Grevy Zebra Trust is working with community conservancies to restore degraded land using their livestock as a tool for regeneration. Given that many herders are in fact children, it was critical to include this demographic in our conservation work.
They, you know, can actually play an active role in the conservation of their rangelands, which support wildlife and the livestock that they're herding. And within schools, the kids have been able to plant trees, They've also taught their fellow students about the importance of having a healthy rangeland to support life in northern Kenya.
Grevy Zebra Trust Reusable Sanitary Pad Project was named the Inkiritan Project by the Scouts. They and other local women have been trained to make the pads, which they sell to communities and to schools. Many girls are forced to drop out of school as a result of their monthly cycle because they have no sanitary protection. This project keeps girls in school, gives women and girls in the community a hygienic option during their cycle, and provides additional income to the women making the pads.
We incorporated zebra stripes onto the reusable sanitary pads because we wanted to make a direct link of this benefit for women's health to the species itself.
Successful Grevy zebra conservation is inextricably tied to the livelihoods of the people living with the zebras. By investing in improving the livelihoods of women and their communities, we strengthen their intrinsic connection to the Grevy zebra.
The warriors are the next generation of leaders, and so engaging them at this time in their lives is really important for building future leadership within the community that really values conservation and values wildlife. In Lysamis, during the dry season, the Grevy zebra go up onto these lava plateaus, which are inaccessible really by vehicle. It's very difficult to monitor the area. And so we came up with the idea of using camels to carry all the camping equipment for the warriors and their food, so that they could actually stay on these plateaus for several weeks at a time. And that enables them to cover the entire area and be able to collect incredibly valuable and rare data on Grevy zebra and also on other wildlife up there.
The warriors' outreach to communities has created a large network of local support for conservation. One of the key threats to Grevy zebra in this region is access to water. We also work with communities across the region to manage existing water points to ensure that Grevy zebra can access water throughout the dry season.
The Grevy zebra ambassador program started in El Bata, which is this incredible area. It's got a lot of resources. It can support a lot of wildlife. Over the years, there's been a lot of poaching in the area for subsistence meat. Wildlife has been decimated from the area. There are two ethnic groups living there, the Samburu and the Takana. And so we engage both of them around conservation. And this has really helped to build good relationships between the two tribes and also bring them together around a cause, which is conserving Grevy zebra and other wildlife.
Using traditional decision-making structures, we are able to resolve conflict and enforce the rules surrounding natural resource governance. To support the Grevy zebra ambassadors in their work, the Grevy zebra Trust established a community-led council of respected elders, warriors, and women from 11 different communities. This team of 33 community leaders is responsible for reaching out to migrating communities, especially warriors, to address illegal hunting and resource use, as well as to foster peace.
My hopes for the future of the Grevy Zebra Trust are to see it become a model for endangered species conservation and recovery that's based on local values, interests, and capacity and local action. For the Grevy zebra as a species, I'd like to see the population start to recover and increase, and to have community-managed areas that provide a refuge for the species so that we can continue to build upon the work that we're doing, knowing that there's a safe haven for Grevy zebra in each place that they are. We couldn't do what we're doing without the support that we've had, both international and local. It's been incredible, and those collaborations with partners and with donors are what makes the Grevy Zebra Trust successful. We are built upon strong partnerships, and we are very grateful to everybody who has supported us.